Okay, so we're getting to an exciting moment. This is an exciting moment in time. You know, what are we really doing here? I have no idea. But we are getting to the point where we are almost ready for this circle, when it reaches this edge of the window, to turn around and come back. Come on, you can do it. Okay, almost. We are getting there. We're ready to do that. So how are we going to do that? We're going to use a conditional statement. That's what the last two videos that you may or may not have watched. One of them was kind of a complete disaster, so you didn't watch that one. We're demonstrating how do conditional statements work. Well, let's take a look at our scenario here. We have a processing window, we have a circle in that processing window. The circle is drawn at an x location of circle x. That is the circle's x location. The circle moves every frame a certain amount. In our program here, we can see it says circle x equals circle x plus 2. So it moves 2 pixels every frame. We can think of that as the x speed, for example. That's the speed it's moving along the x axis. You know, this should really ring a bell for you. What's the thing that we want to add to our program if we're talking about the fact that there's this value that goes here that we could name x speed? Well, we should have a variable for that.
And I kind of jumped the gun with this because that's something we're going to discover. If I had not mentioned that right now, we would discover this in a moment that we need that to be a variable to execute our task. But I'm just going to add another variable at the top. We're going to call it x speed equals 2, and we're going to say circle x equals circle x plus x speed. The nice thing about this is if I decide I want the circle to be really slow because I want to have it like be really dramatic, I could change that to 0.2, and we see we're moving very, 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 very slowly across the screen. So we can let that go for a little bit. We can talk and see if we can get back here before it reaches the edge. That's a good challenge. It's only been 2 minutes so far. We're doing well.
Okay, so first we have to decide for ourselves, what's our condition for when the circle reaches the edge? Well, you can say if the circle's x location is at the width of the window. Well, what does it mean for something to be at the width of the window? Maybe you want to say if it equals the width of the window. If circle x equals width, turn around. That's what we want to say. Turn around. So this is reasonable, but it's a bit of a problem. It's not there yet. See that little ball is still going. Let's get over there. Stop it. Stop it.
Okay. So let's add that bit of code. And I'm going to say if circle x equals the width of the window, do something. Now I'm going to just print a statement. Turn around. So, and I'm also not going to have it go at 0.2 pixels. Let's have it go at 2 pixels, and let's run and see what happens. Oh, I lost my line of code. Somehow I deleted it by accident. Circle x equals circle x plus x speed. Run this again. It's going, it's going, it's going, it's going. In a moment, we should see a little message pop out. Ah, you saw that. So it reached the edge and it printed turn around. I'm sure you can't read that says turn around, but it says turn around. Is that out of the screen? No, it's not out of the screen. It's just out of my preview one. Just ignore me. This is all magic, how this all works. Who knows? Okay. See, this is the problem. I just start like losing my train of thought and a minute goes by. Okay, so we see, but what's the problem with this statement? This is a big problem. This is kind of good, but it's not great. What if I were to say x speed equals, I'm going to make up some number, 2.89. This is really, really important. This is exactly the value that I've always imagined x speed should be. I mean, come on, 2.89826726364. That's such a good speed, right? Okay, so here it goes. Here it goes, we're going to see it's going to get to the edge. It's going to get to the edge. Ooh, wait, nothing printed out. Why? Because if you add this up a bunch of times, it's not going to be exactly 360 pixels. So a much better way of doing this would be to say if circle x is greater than or equal to or greater than the width. This way, if it just so happens that it was here and then the next frame it was here, we're still going to register that. As long as it's gotten past the window, now we want to execute some task. So a little bit of a digression just in sort of dealing with how you deal with something along the edge, but an important one nonetheless. Less, greater than is going to be much better than equals here. Okay, we're at 5 minutes. This is okay. Okay, so now we're good. And we're going to say if it greater than with. Now, just to be simple for a second, I'm going to say, well, how would you say, okay, think, how, what would you write there to have it turn around? Well, how do you get it to go forward? To get it to go forward, you say circle x equals circle x plus speed, right? So to get it to go backwards, you say circle x equals circle x minus speed. So when it gets greater than width, why don't we just tell it to go backwards, right? Okay, that sounds good. I don't know. I like your line of reasoning there. It was pretty reasonable. That's what you were thinking, right? That's not what I was thinking, but that's because I already did this before. Circle x equals circle x minus x speed, right? So let's run that. This seems pretty good. Okay, it's getting to the edge, it's getting to the edge, getting to the edge. It's very dramatic. What's going to happen? Oh, ooh, well, that's kind of a good effect. We got it to stop at the edge. This is a big moment for us. It stopped at the edge, but is it really stopping at the edge? This is where you really, first of all, we could debug this problem by putting a print statement in there and seeing what the value of circle x is. But this is not right. We need to figure out how to get it to turn around. It's not turning around. So what's happening here? Okay, so let's just say for a moment that the value of circle x, it starts at 0. And let's give it a speed of 10. So it's like super fast. This is like the fastest circle moving across the screen you've ever seen. Boom, it's stuck there. It's 10. Is that greater than width? No. So it's 20. Is that greater than width? No. So it's 30. Is that greater than width? No. It's doing that over and over again. Eventually it gets to be 350. Is that greater than width? No. Is 360 greater than width? No. Is 370 greater than width? Yes. So we then say circle x is 370, which equals 370 minus 10. So now it's 360. Is that greater than width? No. So we become 370. It's stuck on the edge. We don't want it. What this is saying here, what this code is saying, is when it gets to the edge, have it go back one time and then keep going forward. And then have it go back one time and then keep going forward. We don't want to do that. We want to say, have it permanently start to go backwards. So how do we have it permanently start to go backwards? Well, it's, why is it permanently going forwards in the first place? It's permanently going forwards because its x speed is 10. So what if I actually here manipulated its x speed value and said x speed equals negative 10? It's zooming across and boom, it's zooming back and ooh, it's gone again. We can accomplish that though. We can deal with that. We can handle it. If circle x is less than 0, set it to go forward. Boom, boom, boom. We have a bouncing ball, ladies and gentlemen. This is very exciting. This is a big moment. What we have now is two conditional statements. One, I'm so confused. I reached to drawing this, but now I've just got this thing here. One is telling it to, whenever it reaches the right-hand side of the screen, to set its speed to be negative. Whenever it reaches the left-hand side of the screen, to set its speed to be positive. Here's the thing. If you're thinking about this, if you've learned about, if you've watched our overly long video about logical operators that had and or in it, could we say, more generically, if it gets to one side of the screen, or if it reaches the other side of the screen, turn around. How could we say turn around? Well, let's think for a moment. 10 means go this way. Negative 10 means go this way. So if the value is 10, we want to switch it to be negative 10. If the value is negative 10, we want to switch it to be 10. How do we reverse the polarity of a number? If it's positive, make it negative. If it's negative, make it positive. Multiply it by negative 1. Then we get negative 10. 10 times negative 1 is negative 10. 10 times negative 10 times negative 1 is 10. Genius. So here we go, and we say, we can say x speed equals x speed times negative 1. And we now have exactly the same effect, but we've reduced it into one statement. If it's greater than width or if it's less than 0, reverse the speed of that. Now, there's a couple things you might try to do as an exercise now that you've watched this video. One is add y, so have it bounce around along the y-axis. Two is have it speed up or slow down each time it hits the wall. This is kind of an interesting problem, and actually I'm going to show you it in a second, so if you don't want the answer to how to make it slow down, pause or quit out for a second. I feel like I'm like the NBC in you know, the Olympics have already happened, but I'm not going to broadcast until later, so I'm telling you to stop watching, but I don't know, never mind. It was ridiculous, right? Okay, so the other thing that you should try is to think about gravity. So how could you make gravity work? And then maybe I'll do a little video about that, but that's sort of like, that's part three, that's a little bit advanced. When we have the system really working, those three exercises will be like right below you, like on this browser page that presumably you're watching this on, whatever. So anyway, just as interesting little token here, we could do something like have it always slow down. This is gonna cause us a problem though, watch. Yeah. Oh, crap. So, you know, those cameras only record for 12 minutes, and for good reason, because I apparently can't get myself to stop. So I'm actually going to leave this here. I'm going to leave this as like this open question. Why did this not work? Why did it suddenly get stuck? I mean, if I increase the speed, it's not going to get stuck. Let's say it gets, and let's start it a little slower because it's going to happen so quickly. So let's say each time it hits a boundary, speed up a little bit. Multiply yourself by 1.1, so you're speeding up by 10%. Right? You can see each time it hits the wall, it starts to go a little bit faster, faster, and faster, and faster, whatever. You can watch this on your own time, because I only got, although it's still recording, but I think I got like 10 seconds left. But as an exercise, and I'll come back to this, why does this break it? Figure that out.